August 10th, 2018, Nicki Minaj dropped Queen.
It's been 2 years. That's crazy to think about. So we figured, what better way to celebrate it than to revisit it in its entirety?
I always felt like through the controversy, the album got buried. And the general public, fans, weren't able to appreciate it as much because we were so focused on everything that surrounded it. So I thought it would be a good idea for us to revisit it where it's just about the music. You know? What did you think of Queen when it first dropped? Like, what was your first reaction to listening to it?
I thought it was good. Genuinely, like, lyrically, it was spot on. I did think that it was a little long. Some songs I felt like weren't, not necessary, but could have been left out. Mm-hmm. And then others were just hits. So it was a little bit of a mixed feeling when I first listened to the album.
I always liked Queen, right? But I was one of those people that was distracted by the controversy, like, I'll admit. I think people fail to realize that with Queen, Nicki wasn't setting out to create hits. It was more so about the art form.
When I listen to Queen, I
see that the focus is really on the production. The focus is on the lyrics.
The focus
is on Queen being, you know, a deeper record. So I think that at the time, with the whole Cardi B thing, and whether Nicki was the queen still or not, they wanted her aim to be a number one. They think that to remain the queen, it's about just about accolades.
So I'm excited to jump back into this album and to listen to it and maybe fall in love with it all over again.
This is gonna be more like a discussion, so I'm excited to dissect Queen.
Yeah.
As the world turns to blunt burns, who's getting at me? Watch them cunts learn. They don't want the witch doctors to bury the Barbie. When I double back, kill bitches, bury the body. I can wage war or I come in peace like Gandhi. Well, my powers back down, scare me to zombies. I ain't giving for them ass, I don't lend my body. Gotta be king status to defend my body. Fuck yeah, cause a queen is what I embody.
I remember when the, like, it leaked.
I know, you remember that?
You gotta have real skill, gotta work for that. If it's really your passion, would you give the world for that? Unlike a lot of these hoes, whether whack or lick, at least I can say I wrote every rap I spit. You could bring anybody, whether man, pick a K. Kobe, KD, Kyrie, pick a K.
So what do you get from Ganja Burn? What do you get from that song?
It's a song about, to me, like, taking back that power. Like, it's definitely, this is one of the songs in the album that tell a story.
Mm-hmm.
A story about triumph, you know, coming back from being knocked down. And lines like, they went to witch doctors to bury the Barbie and just all that stuff. It's definitely a song about triumph.
Agreed.
And yeah.
One of my favorite lines from this song is, I could wage war or come in peace like Gandhi. What people don't understand is, every person Nicki went up against, they were all coming from the same place. And I definitely feel like, you know, with the Nicki hate train and everything, which definitely existed,
absolutely,
there was a plot to take this woman down. Yeah. And I like the fact that on the opening track, she addresses it off bat. We're talking about the topic, but the chorus, I like that it's not specific. I know she wrote and recorded this while she was high. That's just what she was feeling. She was feeling all of those emotions bubbling up. That's what translates through the song.
That part in particular, I think it's just supposed to be one of those things you close your eyes mm-hmm. and just listen to the melody.
I love the way she comes in. Because this just sounds so different.
I remember when this dropped.
Right.
I was
right.
so shocked.
Because we were listening on Queen Radio. And when I heard this, I was like, what? I've never heard Nicki do a sound like this.
Yeah.
I've heard all the songs.
I was so shocked.
So the product, she explored so much through production on this album. I love it.
Yo, I got the money and the power now. The Mac moving like crack. I'm selling powder now.
Hey.
He came over, locked the room, hit the showers now. Just did the deal, Mercedes Benz, check the catalog.
Flex.
I'm buying builders, we don't buy the blog. The Nicki challenge when I fly to Prague. Cause I'm not sucker.
Oh,
shine la la la, boom shine la la la.
Who want it with Nicki now? I smoke on like hippies now. Bitches tones switching up.
We take them to Jiffy now. Oh,
get them peanut butter. He nothing like Skippy now.
Before we even get to Eminem, like, people don't, she snapped on these verses. Yeah.
She invites me to the condo. Uh-oh, white fees in Chicago.
She's tipsy, I'm sober, so she gets a chip on her shoulder. Sits on the sofa, I go to blow the stick breaks on her. Throw some soul, some mischief on. She goes all that old school hip-hop is so fun.
Her genre's that loads are smolder.
It's time to check out the strappers. We need Q-tip for the
a fucking featherweight, I used to medicate it till I get a fucking bellyache, and now I'm finna step on the pedal, don't wanna ever break, I wanna accelerate to a level that I can elevate the middle. Make the motherfucking detonator when I make an acapella. Wait, I gotta set a date with the devil, then celebrate together. We can renovate and redevelop hella weights, and I'ma get a special place now.
And I'm back to rule the kingdom of fuck it, let me keep it 100. Two things shouldn't be your themes of discussion, the queen and her husband. Last thing you're gonna wanna be is our subjects, yeah.
Well, let me hit you back, tell them I'll get you back. I know you're sitting there just thinking about who did you that.
Just got feelings.
What?
I love, and can I say, the way that they end that with the die slow sets the tone for obviously the next track.
Yeah.
Which is Barbie G.
Yeah.
Roman's Revenge and Majesty. Conversation for another day?
Conversation for another day.
It's that beat, oh my god. I'll be honest, when Julian and I saw the track list for Queen, we saw Barbie Dreams, we did not expect something hard. We were like, Barbie Dreams.
Because she's done the sample before on her
right, mixing. Right, Playtime is over.
To see Barbie Dreams, it didn't dawn on me
at all
that it was gonna be that.
At all.
You know?
I'm looking for a nigga to get some babies. If he can't fuck three times a night, please.
One thing about Nicki, she's so comical. The lyrics in Barbie Dreams are so straightforward, like they're like, cutthroat.
There's nothing really even dissect, they're so straightforward.
Yeah.
It's just, you gotta go back and be like, straight shots. Really just say that?
Right.
He's a fucking one of these little rappers. I'm just playing. I'm playing. Like Mike Tyson, he was breaking my shit.
She covered everybody on this song.
When I mean everybody, I mean everybody.
Young and main lady luck, get the strap for this pussy. Had to cancel DJ Khaled, boy, we ain't speaking. Ain't no fat nigga telling me what he ain't eating. YG in the game with the hammer yelling gang gang.
This ain't what I meant when I said a gang bang.
All about the palace, I mean support.
I didn't expect this when we were listening.
I remember when we listened to this, we thought it was a different song.
I couldn't find it on the trap, and I was like, what the heck is this?
We were like, this is the last song? What is this?
Now I let her fuck it again. I got them killing with the shoe. No cylinders in the roof.
Oh, man.
No cylinders in the coupe. I get done with the chrome. No telling when I'm a shoe. I just bang, bang, bang. With killers is in my group. Gorillas is in my unification. And we're extremely not shang, shang, shang. I got me to limit my kids. I'm in the
love
that.
Yes,
baby, we're I be like, fuck em, fuck em. Bring a Lubin. I be like, fuck em, fuck em. Bring a Lubin.
Okay, can we note this, right? Because I'm noticing it. I'm really trying to listen to how cohesive this album is, right? So far, up to track 3, Majesty and Barbie Dream specifically, I'm noticing that she's setting up... this is what irritates me, right? This is why I say Queen is underrated. Majesty set up Barbie Dreams. Barbie Dreams set up Rich Sex. Not only is it a comical song, mainly that last bit of Barbie Dreams, Nicki's enunciation.
Incredible. Incredible.
She does not slur her words.
Incredible. Incredible. There is
you don't miss a thing.
There isn't a time where you're like, what was that? Play that back. Every single syllable is
pronounced. Every syllable.
Every word. Yeah, she, when it comes to rapping fast, that girl can
spit. She's just...
And you hear everything. Before we get into Rich Sex, Jordan can attest to this. I hated this song. I hated the cover, the bob.
But it grew on you.
But it just grew on me over time.
And I said it would.
And, yeah.
Full blown.
It feels like a mixtape track. I love it.
Moolah.
And that bass.
I know what these niggas like, and it ain't my charm.
I ain't stupid.
This 250 on my arm. Ass out, pussy fat, 22 a rich nigga. Move on, Rico, it's me paying for my money, Mitch nigga.
One of the dopest lines in the song. Who gon' Rico ace me paying for my money? Like, come on, like, that's crazy.
Got him calling nonstop, cause he don't wanna miss this.
I said, don't panic, keep the faith. Big bitch, come on. She's so slick.
It'll almost blow over your head.
It's a shot, but like, facts though.
Rich sex. Don't let homie fuck unless his bands up.
Just makes you wanna
go to DR, get that fat fans
Now you looking rich, bitch.
Pussy smell like money when I'm down there. That's a rich
sex. I love that. I don't think that real rich
rich who? That place too. The rich get richer. That's my ritual.
I've rich, always loved
rich
that.
Rule, rich rule. That's how I take
always
it.
Always loved that.
Next stop, New York.
See what I mean? See, when she says next stop, New York, and the next song is Hard White, she's constantly setting that up. Setting that's up. Something that we have to acknowledge within this album. I would have loved to see Cash Doll at the time on it. I think that she would have been great on that track. It would have kept that woman empowerment theme as well. Because at this point in the album, if you haven't noticed yet, the album isn't just called Queen to reference Queen of Rap. The album is called Queen because it's pushing woman and women empowerment. Because, you know, people automatically assume, well, she's calling her Queen because she's the Queen of Rap. No. She's calling her Queen because, yes, she is the best at what she does. Absolutely. But there's a common theme here. And I think we're even going to see that in Hard White.
Work hard just to get high back.
It's one of the best hooks on the
work
album.
Work hard just to get high back. Get into it that way. I ain't coming through and left the back straight. I used to just last week. I told him to pick a side. I brush shots. Don't duck if it don't apply. Mirror, mirror, who's the fairest? You big motherfucking fairest. Would I drop on his watch? I don't know about the hundred.
I love when in songs when she responds to herself.
I'm who they wishing to be. These hoes is on the gram, Nicki pitching the key.
Oh, top, never land. I wanted to dissect that so bad.
You might as well took a plea.
Obviously, if you know the difference between a gram and a kilo, again, implying and reiterating, you're less than me.
It almost doesn't sound like her.
Almost not, but it just sounds so good with this look.
Yeah.
It's the perfect blend, I think, of all her talents.
Yeah.
I don't know why I'm just catching that
they
just
see
now.
A downgrade.
Bad girl
whip,
the top is off. You know the cars?
Yeah.
She's saying that the roof of the car is off.
Yes.
I don't know why I'm just catching that, but that's a dope line too. The whole knock it off, cock it off, crop it off,
that whole,
chop it off, all of that,
all that.
That right there just solidified that this song is one of the best.
Yeah.
I ain't never played a whole position. I ain't never had to strip to get the pole position.
Everybody thought that was about Curtis.
Any chance that could actually be about Eve?
Hmm.
Do you remember what Eve said on, I think it was The Talk or whatever that show, about Nicki's cover?
I don't know. It's besides.
It's a dope line, regardless.
Regardless.
And I ain't moving weight, but I'm in the dope position. You know, dope.
Yeah.
All that.
Yeah.
Just last week, I told him to pick a side.
Hard White is the perfect title for the song because it's just hard.
Nothing else to say. I really have nothing else to say.
That's it. I never have to strip to get the pole position could also be a response to Remy and her claim she made on Sheether.
You got a bed with somebody's name on it?
No.
She have that with your name on it?
Nope.
That
shot
to
the beat
of the
I do like
that.
Ariana sounds so pretty on this chorus. It makes me wanna, you know, be on the beach with a pina colada and just
move around. It just vibe. Yeah.
I'm trying to dance on him, blow my advance on him. I like him better when he got some sweatpants on him. I watch him fuck it up, look at him looking up. I said you need some thick skin, baby, suck it up.
I know Nicki was considering at one point putting Zayn on this. I think he could have sounded really good.
Yeah.
Like if he did a bridge or something or even had a verse maybe. I think Zayn would have fit really well. Nicki, Ariana, and Zayn.
Yeah.
That would have been dope.
That would have been dope.
So, how do we feel about the transition from Hard White to Bed?
Bed is one of those where it could potentially throw you off because it is so pop heavy, and you just had four in particular.
Hip-hop inspired.
Heavy hip-hop inspired songs.
Yeah, I don't know, I just feel like it might have been too much of a shift.
Mm-hmm.
I think the song fits the vibe of the album well, but I think maybe Bed could have been moved down.
More.
Like, I would have moved Bed down and Thought I Knew You up. Hard White to Thought I Knew You could have been a little smoother.
Mm-hmm.
But
mm-hmm.
let's get into Thought I Knew You. I love that bass line.
I love this.
honestly. There was one point where I thought maybe the song could have been seen as lazy, but I don't think it's lazy. I just think it's straightforward. Like, I thought I knew you. Guess I didn't. It's that simple, you know?
Yeah, love the song.
This is speaking to becoming heartless after a heartbreak.
I do remember that when she dropped this and she was speaking on Queen Radio, she said that she would consider going back and adding a rap verse because there was an original rap verse.
Yeah. Did you see it?
And I can see it, but I think I've grown to like the song without it.
In the beginning, I think I was curious.
I was like, why didn't you do that? And then when you listen to it, I'm like, you know what? No, it was just the right amount of her, and it was just the right amount of The Weeknd.
The light is coming in strong, so if you see lines through our faces, ignore them.
Yeah.
This is definitely where the album,
Don't be goofy, bring some passion to the table, what you doing? Don't be stupid, I'm the realest, but you know, yeah, I'm the truest. Cause it's been a minute since I trusted somebody. Cause I don't ever put my trust in nobody. I hate to picture you out fucking somebody. So I don't ever put my trust in nobody.
I love that line. I like when her vocals kind of echo in the back. Like after a note, it'll echo in the back. I always felt that Run and Hide felt more like a interlude. It's moving at a slower pace.
Yeah.
But it kind of feels like the breakup between.
For a lot of people, Run and Hide is a hit or a miss. For me, in the beginning, it was a miss. And then I actually took the time to appreciate it. And it's, honestly, to me, one of the best songs on Queen.
Really?
Just if you take the time to actually listen to it and feel it and vibe.
Mm-hmm. This is obviously the section of the album where it starts to slow down. I think that didn't help it. Because Run and Hide is one of Nicki's best vocal performances. Throughout her discography, in my opinion, it really is. Mm-hmm. But I think people didn't appreciate it as much because they were getting bored.
Mm-hmm.
Which is why I say at this point in the album, I think something had to change.
Mm-hmm.
You have Bed, Thought I Knew You, Run and Hide. Yeah. Something had to break up that flow, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
This is that section of the album which is being vulnerable. You know, I think a lot of times when we think of Queens, we think strong exterior.
Mm-hmm.
And she's kind of saying, no, like... you get hurt, we still get hurt, you know what I mean? Yeah, we still get hurt. There's always that section where... she slows it down and opens up.
Yeah.
One of the best beats, though.
Ooh, hard beat.
Maybe this is the tick up that I was looking for. Maybe this is where, like, if she moved this track up, I just think that at some point the album had to reignite. You know what I mean? I think this is the song that could have did it.
Not at 6 minutes. Every girl is coming like a shark. Ain't no necklace. I like his parts though. Say no ski resort. Who the fuck gone party with the dolly? Someone never did a money. Never hit you, then you probably gone stop. Who the fuck gone copy with the body? Always looking like a hottie. Always saying what somebody won't do. Who the fuck beat him with the 22? If he don't lose the attitude, I'm running with his credit card too.
I'm the one that gets I'm legit vibes from that.
Yeah.
I'm the only one.
No, not the only one. I've never thought about that.
Let me just address that bar real quick. Everything on point like on guard.
Yeah.
Like a sword?
Yeah.
That's dope.
Yeah.
Anything I like goes in the car.
They deliver my Lambo or a white with a tan bow. My body's a work of art.
He eating his Van Gogh.
Shout out Giovanni for doing that Bobby Sings video.
This part always gave me mixtape vibes.
Uh-huh. Mixtape vibes, that's what I like about it.
See ya, Stephen Gann, L. Matt. You're in the middle of Queen right now, thinking, I see why she called this shit Queen.
This bitch is really the fucking Queen.
I love my fans. I love you so much.
I love you so much.
I don't know. I like the length of Chun Sui, and I like how raw it is because it just it feels wholesome.
Yes.
You know?
It's just when you realize that that's track 9, it could just go on for a little too long, depending on the type of mood you're in while listening to it. Sometimes the whole 6 minutes is a complete and utter vibe, and you're like, dang, that was it?
And
other times you're like, oh, okay, it's still going on.
I can agree. I mean, so, the length has never bothered me, but I can see what you mean. It's like you gotta be in the mood.
In the mood to listen to
listen to something that long. I like the fact that Chun Sui leads into Chun Li.
Yeah.
This is definitely where the album takes another turn, you know? We're entering a new
era. Hey, yo. Look like I'm going for a swim. While I'm coming up the court, fully drenched.
Yeah.
Been on, bitch, you been con. Bentley tints on, Fendi prints on.
The animation in this chorus is so good.
He keep on dialing Nicki like the prince on. Oh, I get it.
Enemy out to meet a bad guy.
Well, it's the last time you wanna see a bad guy do the rap game like me.
I think this was such a creative way for her to address the hate train and being painted as a bad guy. This was the most creative way, and even like having the video in mind too, just
I love this.
Really well done.
This is King Kong. Yes, I'm King Kong. This is King Kong. Yes, Miss King Kong. You're in my kingdom with my Tim's on.
How many championships?
Why is this rings on? So they can get on their fucking keyboards and make me the bad guy.
See, she's addressing it. I love it.
Hey, yo, I've been on. Bitch, you been con. Bentley Tim's on. Fendi Prince on.
I'm in my song. Yes.
That's who produced it. Yes. Man, he did Chun Li and Barbie Tinks. Chun Li has such a hard beat.
Yeah.
And it's like all the bells and whistles, the brum brum, brum 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 brum, and then it's the.
I love this song.
It
had punch back then, it has punch now. I'm not gonna lie. Album so far, album's here, right?
Mm-hmm.
It drops just a little bit, just a little bit. Chun Li just like takes
it. Yeah, Chun Li shoots it up.
And takes it to 10.
I just took her name and made that bitch an LLC. Stuff a couple stacks up in there, bitch, get on.
We're definitely in that playful part of the album.
Just to see. So you be rich and famous, you just a guy to me. I feel like I'm King Kong. Name still going ding dong. Two girls getting more money.
They don't rap, they sing songs. And I like that. That's a little, what do you call it? That's a little reference to, I would guess, the Holy Trinity. No? Because they've never addressed the Holy Trinity, but
I think that's getting more money and they don't rap.
Obviously, Beyonce and Reed.
And
took a little break, but I'm back to me. Trying to make a new nigga with a factory. They'll never toe to toe on a track with me. They'll never be another one after me.
I just want to point out Blasphemy and Blasphemy. I've always loved her play on words with that. I've always loved it.
I just took her name and made that bitch an LLC. Stuff a couple stacks up in and bitch, get on your feet. You made me fucking
told you get low. Like, is she shooting?
I'm New York, Nick. I'm ballin' with Carmelo. I'm wavy, worth that shouty. Hello, hello.
So even going down to take a little break now, back to me, trying to make it to me without a blah, 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 blah. It's just the truth, you know? Yeah. This is a successful woman. Everybody wants their own Nicki.
Look at what they made me do. They made me do. Switch the foreign on a navy blue. The baby blue. All my niggas move that Britney Army.
That white.
Yes,
she does that a lot throughout the album where it goes out and then it comes back in.
I can't like it though.
That laugh, man. Alright, so yeah, LLC.
LLC has always been a good song.
Yeah, it's a solid track. Miss, you want to do that little.
Hola, 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 okay, hola. You see a bad bitch coming to you with a hola.
I'm in a new movie, and you know what I got up.
I told a valley, pop my bands and bring a rosa. Cause I beat a fatty beat, Bobby Tink, bring your body.
She snapped. Who's on the production on this one, too?
Bitch got more coins than the game room.
And literally, this is a good song.
It's really good, yeah.
See, I keep my son.
Wait, wait, that line. So we ain't never hating in the shade room. That's a shot at all of y'all.
Telling me to cookie cause it's good form. And when he eats a cookie, he got good form.
Is that little?
He know I don't ever cheat because I'm good form. My dad that had his baby needs his gonna push form. You see, I let him eat the cookie cause it's good.
And that, is that a string? It's a synth.
Yeah,
it's a synth. Oh, it's
beat.
And the sample. What's the sample again? Shake That Monkey, I think it's a sample.
Come on.
Now this next verse. No, you know the part I gotta say because I can't have a sense
of like, well, listen. He love me good form. Come on.
Now there has been speculation about what that line is about. There has been some speculation that it has been about Offset when he got in that car crash.
Now, that's a stretch.
That's a bit of a stretch. I've seen that, so every time I hear that line, I think about it.
Cause I need a baddie beat, Bobby tape.
Oh, this song.
Woo!
Contemporary Majesty Barbie Dreams.
Yes.
Chun-Li LLC Good Form. There's three combinations.
Yes.
Those two combinations, man, those are two highlights in the album. That's what I'm saying. Like, if she brought this in earlier, the album would have picked right back up.
Mm-hmm.
I got to rest this beat. And when that beat comes back in. Bum, 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 bum. It's that part.
Yeah.
Good Form is.
Yeah. When this song plays, I don't want to hear a peep out of you. The only peep I want to hear is me and Nikki, because this is me and Nikki's song.
Oh. Whew. Can I just say one thing?
Mm-hmm.
The production on this song is really good as well. Like, if you really listen to the beat,
mm-hmm.
and it really helps when you have headphones in.
Ooh.
It's good.
Can you write that? Yeah. Thinking and take it all back. Okay, I'm out to twist the chop on you. Snip, snip, hit the name top on you. Let go, tryna give up on you. Still use the car, niggas like you. Swerve, 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 niggas like you. Even though I heard what you might do, I didn't get concerned cause I liked you. I don't know, I'm out to twist the chop on you. Snip, snip, hit the name top on you. Rain, rain, never kick up on you. Like you, I get petty and clip niggas like you. Fuck around and forget niggas like you. Promise I can never miss niggas like you. So no, I need more than what you got for me. You got a bad bitch.
It's similar to Running Higher. Yeah,
you gonna need to take it all back.
Take it all back.
Okay, right then. Yeah, you don't know what to do with all that. And that's another thing. Give up on them. I don't even want to get up on him. And I ain't trying to work it out, but I'm at the gym on the mat doing sit-ups on
him. Nice.
You let yourself go. You don't represent O. So trust me, just go. You settle for less, yo. You disrespectful. Come off my pedestal. Money off that edible. Which means the back's that tight. You ain't got to drive my nigga get pedestaled.
Can we just acknowledge that section?
Mm-hmm.
Come off that pedestal. Money off that edible. Which means them bags stacked high. You ain't got the drive. Your pedal stalled.
Pedal still drive.
The way she carried that all the way through, you have to acknowledge
stacked
that.
High, edible. Woo!
Yeah, the way she carried that through.
Yeah.
Good execution.
Who the fuck you thought you was trying to stun on Nick? Should've put you on blast like a gun on a hit. But it's okay, we gon' keep secrets, nigga. Cause a true bad bitch ain't weak or bitter.
Cause a true bad bitch ain't weak or bitter. That is... a fact.
Jordan had to tap me because I can't always I can't help but rap and sing every part of that song Nip Tuck always leaves me feeling...
Yeah.
No words.
How do you think it would have been if Nip Tuck was moved up?
No.
Agreed.
I think Nip Tuck...
Yeah.
Chun-Li, LLC, good form, Nip Tuck.
They were genuinely perfect.
This is actually the first interlude Nicki's ever had on the album.
It is.
So, I think... There was speculation that this was a full song with...
It was. She said it herself. She said it was a full song. And she debated on putting that out, too.
Yeah. So. I would actually like to hear it. But let's get into Too Late, Too Late interlude. You should have been listening. People thought I was just listening.
I know, right?
Why you ain't listening,
listen
back then? Now you too much, too little, yeah, too late.
You know, I think, honestly, I think it's good as an interlude. I've never liked the title Too Lit, Too Late. I think she should have just called it Too Late Interlude. That's just a personal opinion. And I think that this actually could have been a cool deluxe track. If she called it Too Late.
Smart.
And did the full song as a deluxe track, that'd be cool.
I can't help but smile because I love this song.
It's a good song. It's one thing to be versatile, but it's another to be versatile and good at it. I think this could have been a single. To be honest with you.
Think so?
Because I know a lot of people that actually know this song. With a video and everything, I could have seen her looking out the window. Was it raining? Just waiting on him to come see about her. How do you feel about the pacing so far?
Good.
Yeah. Pull up.
Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. Pull up.
I'm whipping foreigns
to make them go faster.
That's
a hard line.
Come on. The way she carried that, sir, is a really clever song in itself, even just the title.
Just to be able to
rhyme
the word. And keep that momentum.
Throughout the entire verse,
you know?
The entire verse.
Yeah.
Say it's the fresh print as she sir. Call me AI, sir. I'm the answer. I'm in the playoffs.
Look at that. Just call me AI, sir. I'm the answer. Allen Iverson. That's just... I used to think that she was talking about it on a, like, technology tip. It could be a double entendre in that way.
Yeah, it could be double entendre.
Because you know we run to, obviously, artificial intelligence for our answers. And you ask Google and stuff. I could be reading too deep, but I that's how I took it as well. That's what you're... The singing in the background.
On the gas, sir. On the gas, sir. Spurs your gas, sir. Blowing gas, sir. Cocaine up in the jack bar, sir. Stars in the ceiling, served up in the attic, sir.
I love this. I've always loved this little strength. And I like how Nicki comes back in.
Shoot my man, sir. Shoot my man, sir.
Can I say, okay. I think that while listening to Sir, what I looked forward to the most came in the beginning with Nicki's verse. I was looking forward to the bars and how she was going to end every bar with Sir. Future did the same thing, but the quality dropped. And on one hand, I could be like, oh, at that point, you know, we're just vibing to the beat and we're vibing to
Cause Future. Because Future is really just a vibe, yeah.
But lyrically, I think I was looking forward to them raising the bar every time.
Future may have dropped it just a little bit because Future's more of a vibe. Nicki is definitely a lot more lyrical.
Right.
Sir for me is, you know, one of them skips.
You think so?
But I don't discredit it lyrically.
I do think it's one of those tracks that could have been left off the album.
Not the movie.
Could have been. I mean, but I don't mind it, but it's like, it is getting dark, so just bear with us with the lighting, but
I'm not going to say too much, but you know, Nip Tuck, and then Miami, and that's what I'm gonna leave it at.
Just the beat.
I like her cadence.
Nicki's talking big on this song.
One time, Mr. Sickest, Mortal Kombat, Ninja Nicki, who your pick is?
Who is this?
Patty Do. Patty Do. It's so like.
Yes, I buried them.
Wait.
I buried them when they come for me. Call me Hallie.
Facts. Woo! Facts.
Yeah. Since I finished her, call me the finale.
Birth to the palace, this the queen's like a palace, put $15 million on it. Ask LL, I'm doing it. Don't get cute and run it. All my skill, I hone it. I hit the opponent. It look easy, don't it?
Yo, Nick, what's good? It's your boy, Daddy Duke. Now, you already know we got shit moving out here, man. Iconic shit, man.
That is such an underrated song lyrically. I think that is honestly one of the best songs on this album.
I agree with you that it is a good song.
If it's slander, I don't even want to hear it.
But I think Miami could have been left off.
All right, guys, on the track 18.
No, but listen. It's not the song itself. It could just be the placement. Miami makes sense down here, but it's almost like after Sir, then Miami. I'm like, okay.
I mean, I
just felt like the album was dragging a little bit.
I get
here.
It. Everybody has a wrong opinion. I get it.
Put on the gangster.
This song makes me want to get my Glock.
The just Glock like, that I don't have.
Hey, yo, Chun, back on that Uncle shit. Number one, huh? It's that Rick Ross, huh?
She's real big with it, you know?
It's getting go-go.
Yeah, just a go-go.
If I'm in the Gurkha, then they in the back of it. If I tell them eat food, then they make a snack of it. That's worth a Brooklyn, that's worth a Bucktown, that's worth a Harlem World.
Shout out to Uptown.
Ran down when I come round. All your bitches bad ass. King Fox and King Kong. Back on my chummy.
That's my boy. Gunslingers. Let me see your gun fingers. Little Nicky's little ingers. I just think that, I don't know.
Perfect fit. There's something about her verse that just like, ties the song together.
Ties the song together like it makes so much sense.
Nobody could have done it like Foxy.
It's like that Monica meme where she goes, that's director Remy.
That's a switch up, guys. That's French Sandro. Kalanji Cartel, Bujo, Rosso, Super, Cat all over his Ferragamo. I know, bless up, by Marley, yes, King Lion. Marching, the Roman Hill to Zion. Caribbean Kings, what I on? Me and Fox getting paper like with Ain't Dryon. Woo! I think that that is like
Ain't Dryon, mic drop. You know what I mean?
And the fact that she was able to tie in all those names, like, this is a lyricist right here. And I think that that's the whole point of this album.
Yeah.
So first, let's address Coco Chanel. Coco Chanel is—it's just the finale track.
It's a great song.
It's the finale track. It was a great way to close the album.
It makes you feel so rough and street, yeah. That island vibe and the sample from that "Bun Up the Dance." Coco Chanel is definitely one of, I think, the highlights, especially.
I agree. Feature. No, I totally agree with you.
Feature being, you know.
But I think to appreciate it, you have to get it.
Yes.
You know what I mean? You have to understand.
Yeah, Coco Chanel is a great song. So that is Queen in its entirety 2 years later. Yeah. How do you feel about the album now?
Being that we listen to this focusing on the music and focusing on it for what it is and not what we wished it was at the time, I appreciate this album.
Yeah.
Because you can tell the focus, like I said in the beginning, was on the production and the lyricism. Mm-hmm. It wasn't about aiming for a hit. I feel like this is a perfect addition to Nicki's discography. This was a necessary addition to Nicki's discography.
I have to agree. I do feel like how I did when the album first dropped. My biggest thing is that at a certain point, it can feel a little bit long. I feel like I'm always gonna feel like that, kind of like, oh, you know, some songs could have been shortened, left out. Mm-hmm. Some deluxe songs, you know? Lyrically, this album is perfect.
Yeah.
Like, she took her time, like Jordan said, with the production, with the lyricism.
Cultivating the flows, like it was just...
With the features, I feel like every feature is picked out perfectly.
They serve their purpose. Yeah, exactly.
That's it right there. This album is honestly great listening to it again. Certain things I didn't appreciate. Certain things in the beat I didn't hear. And so listening to it again, I just appreciate it all over again. And it just proves why she is the queen of rap.
Absolutely.
It just proves it. It just proves it.
With the women empowerment, men are always talking about how the woman is in the bed.
Yeah.
Good Form flips that on its head and talks about how men are in the bed. Nip Tuck is obviously a women empowerment song.
Yeah.
Come See About Me brings that vulnerability. LLC is about dominating your field. Chun-Li is that pushback at all the haters that have something to say, you know?
Yeah,
I already touched on Barbie Dreams, Majesty, Rich Sex, all of them. They all are, in essence, about women empowerment. I think that's why this album is appropriately called Queen. As always, let us know your thoughts in the comments below. We would love to hear what you have to say about Queen.
If you guys enjoyed this album review, please leave a like, comment, and don't forget to subscribe. More importantly, go ahead and press that little notification bell so you know every time we upload.
We out!